continue the series of our lessons of making such a container. A basket, a candy box, whatever you call it. Today we will start painting this item. We will get to know the first method of painting for the beginners, the simplest one. When we have made a basket from newspaper tubes, we prepare a mixture for painting. We take some container, add white acrylic color used for painting of walls and ceilings. Add some water and some PVA glue. Mix it thoroughly until it becomes smooth. And start painting. I have chosen the toughest brush from my store to paint all the holes thoroughly. If we see that the paint is not thick enough, of course, when it gets dry, the effect will be different. But to be on the safe side, we can add some more paint. Paint thoroughly with a tough brush, the bottom. The side walls. Paint these places abandoned very thoroughly. While painting the knobs, one should be careful not to leave these places here unpainted. Because we don't see them from this angle, and it happened with me a couple of times that these areas remained unpainted. Turn the item. Now, when we have spread the paint mixed with school glue and water, that is, we have primed it. It is time when we can correct the defects. For example, we can straighten the knobs if they don't seem straight enough, trim the shape of our candy box. It is very flexible now. After it thickens, we won't be able to do this. But now it is high time. Notice that special attention while painting should be paid to the places of connection of knobs. In order to paint all the holes, all the uneven places very, very thoroughly. It looks like that so. We repeat the same action with the lid. I draw your attention to the places of connection of the knob, to the places of bending places here and there. So, we have primed our item. We leave it to dry. In summer, a couple of hours in the sun will be enough, maybe even faster. In winter, I usually leave it for the night near the radiator. We have two more stages ahead. Spreading of mordant and varnish. The item has gotten dry. We can start the next stage, spread the mordant. I've chosen the mordant of fumed oak color. It is rather dark, We'll see what it is going to look like. The modern socks in well, but still in some places unpainted areas can be seen. We stain it especially thoroughly in the places of connection of the knobs. And in the places of banding.
Точно так же скрываем молиткой в нашу крышку.
If there are unpainted places left, we take a thinner tough brush and get rid of these unpainted areas, these defects this way. And the last stage of decoration of the completed item is varnishing. I use acrylic varnish. It is called panel glossy varnish. It doesn't smell, it is very convenient for use. About 10 minutes have passed since I was using spirit mordant. If you use water mordant, more time should pass. In my case, 10 minutes is enough. I spread the varnish. This stage is faster. Side walls. So, we have varnished the item itself, the lid. I asked you to pay special attention to inside of the knobs. It is where unpainted areas often remain, and to paint the knob of the lid thoroughly. I propose after you have finished varnishing, if you have no opportunity to hang it for drying onto the fence or some pin in the fresh air, to leave it for drying on the oilcloth. Because from my experience, I know that varnish sticks to the paper, and when there are paper remainders left, it doesn't look nice. That is why I will leave it on the oilcloth, because there is no opportunity for drying it outside now. And wait some time for the acrylic varnish to dry. It doesn't take much time, 20-30 minutes. And after getting dry, our candy box look like this. At the first sight, one can think that it is braided from vise.